In this video series, I'll teach a simple method for editing interviews by breaking down the process step by step and saving you a lot of time. My name is Eduardo Voivoda. I'm the owner of CROMO, a video production company based in Northern Italy. We specialize in commercials, but we also occasionally produce and co-produce documentaries. This is the first of three videos, and I will teach you the basics of syncing, creating multi-clips, and editing multi-camera interviews in just one track. Editing interviews is a slow process that requires a lot of experience. By following this method, you can start learning the important lessons without losing time on the technical aspects of your program. The first step is to import your files and organize them properly. As I mentioned in my essential tips video, you should create folders for each file type and subfolders for each scene. My usual structure is files, video, date 01, and then 101 interview, followed by the name of the interviewee. Put all of the video files from all cameras and the audio recordings in this folder. Now we need to sync the different files with each other. Your first instinct might be to drag all files into a timeline and try to sync them manually or by using the auto-line clips function, which syncs the audio by matching the audio waveforms. This is not the best way to sync files for two reasons. First, you're occupying multiple video tracks for the same content, since each camera feed will be on a new track. This means having to make the same cut multiple times, once for each track. The second reason is more technical. Often, especially with lower-end cameras, the audio from the clips is not perfectly synced with the video due to internal processing delays. This means that your audio might be slightly out of sync with the video. Additionally, while video moves at the speed of light, audio travels at 343 meters per second, which is much slower. If your camera is far away from the subject, the audio will be slightly delayed compared to the video. At a distance of 343 meters, the audio will arrive a full second later. This isn't usually an issue with interviews, but there's a way to be sure there's no delay. Let's see how to sync files without audio delays and while keeping editing consistent with the one-track method I explained in my previous video. The first step is to find a sync point between the clips. This is where the clapperboard or movie slate is useful. The slate creates a loud noise that's easy to identify in both the video and the audio files. Open the audio file, listen for the take number, and look for the audio spike from the slate. Use the arrow keys to find the first frame with the spike. If you can't hear it, use a Shift plus S to enable audio scrolling. Once you've found it, place an endpoint. Now move to the video. Check the slate number to make sure it matches with the audio, then place an endpoint on the first frame where the slate's sticks touch. As you can see, the red Gemini we use for this take has a one-frame video delay compared to the audio. By placing the endpoint here, you avoid any sync problems as the video and audio are perfectly aligned. If you don't have a slate, you can use any clear visual cue, such as two hands clapping.
Axel, take uno.
Place an endpoint on the first frame where the hands meet. Repeat this process with the rest of the camera angles in your interview. You should now have an endpoint on every file that needs to be synced. Now select all the video files you need to sync, the audio file or files, and all the camera angles of the same take. Right-click and select Create New Multicam using selected clips. A pop-up window will appear. Change the name of the multicam clip to something clear. I usually write int for interview, then the name of the interviewee, and then the take number. You can add multicam or group at the end of the name to remind yourself that it's a multiclip. Select in as angle sync. Lastly, you can choose to move all the selected clips to a subfolder called original clips by toggling around this box. I usually leave this off. Now, press create. A new file will appear in your project. This is the multicam clip. If you double-click on it, you'll see that all video files are now contained in the same clip. You can now start editing. Create a new timeline following the naming convention I discussed in previous videos. Client, project name, V1 for version, and interview selection. Now listen to all your interviews, place an in and out points on the parts you're interested in. Make sure V1 and A1 are selected in the timeline. Finally, drag and drop the clip into the timeline viewer, and the video will appear on the timeline. Repeat this process for all parts you want to include. Once you're done, you can start switching camera angles. To switch camera angles, right-click on the clip in the timeline, hover on Switch Multicam Clip Angle, then select the angle you want. The entire clip will switch and stay in sync. As you can see, with this method, you don't need more than one track for interviews. You can also switch the audio angle by selecting the audio and switching to the angle that includes the external recorded audio. You can also select the video and audio angles before editing by right-clicking the Multicam clip in the project, selecting Switch Multicam Audio Angle, and choosing the correct audio file. Beware that this selection is not permanent and will be removed if you click on one of the videos in the Multicam clip in the clip viewer or if you load other clips. To avoid changing the selection, you can edit using the shortcuts F9 for insert and F10 for overwrite. You can also switch cameras mid-sentence by creating a ghost cut in the clip using the blade tool, then switching one of the two angles.
Until we can have algorithms and machines that feel that, we won't have machines who care.